Every week I cross swords with my nemesis, my torturer. He's simply known as DA in the Sydney Morning Herald and The Age. But just who is this guy who constantly breaks my brain?
My name is David Astle, alias DA, and my job is a crypto cruciverbalist.
There's Wolverine, which is an anagram of lover inside wine.
I think what distinguishes a DA crossword is that it seems relatively lenient when you first glance at it, and then you find after the first look around that you've got one or no clues at all. But if you put faith in me, like any solver needs to do in a setter, in the end, I will deliver the answer. But you will need to swing the bat at that pinata nice and hard. I don't spill my lollies easy. I always loved words and riddles, double meanings, homophones, spoonerisms, suburb names in number plates. I must have some wiring going on in my brain that sees words and strange patterns inside names and words. And one way of looking at it is that my preoccupation has become my occupation. It almost chose me.
Rhapsodic. I love the word, I love its meaning, but also there's a lovely musical echo to the word too, because the first syllable sounds like a style of music, rap, and the last five letters you can mix up into another style of music, disco. So it's got a lot of musical things going for it.
A lovely favourite word. Well, thank you, David.
I think a good crossword clue should tell a story. So it's the combination of definition and the wordplay.
So they're all nines. Charlotte has harlot inside it. Teddy bear, Teddy's lingerie bear, feels like naked. It's a bedfellow.
My favourite clue and favourite type of clue is called an and lit. The wordplay is literally the definition. For example, I melt lard. And if you possibly mix up I melt lard, you get treadmill, which melts lard. So those sorts of clues are the Da Vinci's. They're the little, you know, moments, the masterpieces you try and pursue. But the challenge for me as a setter is to try and come up with a recipe that's never been tried before.
They're rhyming slang, so Pat Malone and Frog and Toad, that was a theme where every second entry was a piece of rhyming slang.
And I love the challenge that every word throws down to you, saying, what are you going to make of me today? It's very hard to typify the classic person who is drawn to my crossword. I've had a young couple straight out of uni who have basically developed a relationship over my crosswords, and I helped to put the wedding proposal together. And I've also had people every age and shape and size and background in between. I think crosswords are so popular because they scratch an itch which very few other things can reach. So I am the more difficult setter, but in the end, I will deliver you answers and jollies and ahas.